Hey guys, welcome back. Tonight it's a little bit different until 1 o'clock, or at least until when everything settles down in Red Dead, and then we'll be, riding on horseback and whatnot, but for now we're just going to do some farming and whatnot until the, at least until everything settles down in Red Dead, which is at 1 o'clock. Now I don't know if you play Fortnite at 1 o'clock, everything kind of settles down, or if it's just, well, actually it's probably just no minor, but still, that's crazy. Okay, we're gonna buy a harvester here. Let's see, where can I see, we got any good harvesters here that we could be? Black glass, that's like window tinted glass, normal. White wheels, windows. Oh, that's kind of, what? Auxiliary wheels? What the heck are auxiliary wheels? I'm gonna forget that's even a thing, because that is actually really weird. That's weird. Oh, since we're gonna go, we better go with something big and something powerful, something that can hold a lot of grain. Get that. This right here, that's kind of a decent sized case. Axaflow with the extension. United States version. Trailer hitch. White tires. Traction along a pipe. There we go. And then we go boom, boom. And then we will get some. We'll get a corn. Or a, we'll get a header for it. We'll get the header trailer that's connected. Rasta mesh would probably be the appropriate size, but we want to match. Well, hostile. Rasta mesh is the same color. This case is, yeah, it's about just about the same color. I want to be able to at least get this 362, this 3162 teraflow. Tripper 45 foot header in the farm, which is going to be quite impossible. I gotta teleport to the ship, okay? Hey, by the way, you see the train in there? It's going 49 miles an hour, and it's glitched inside the mountain. Like no clickbait. You see? It's floating. Apparently there's still some bugs in the game that still needs to be fixed, but let's get into it. I didn't record a video last night, guys. I wouldn't say stressed, but I've been really tired and a lot lately, so I kind of had to, you know, catch up on some Z's, and sleep and whatnot, you know, just for my health and whatnot, so I didn't, because I seen a video or whatever on YouTube or whatever, it was this guy or this kid that played Fortnite for like, I think like guy said 45 hours or something like that, or all night, without taking a bathroom break, or, you know, without sleep, or even resting his eyes, and his heart completely stopped. So I kind of don't want that to happen to me, so I'm kind of trying to keep my heart beating, of course. so I can still give you guys good content and whatnot, so. I'm gonna make it a little bit more realistic by turning on the traffic. As much as I don't want to, because the traffic are in this map are absolutely horrible. And you'll see why. Once a car comes in, you'll definitely see why. Oh, this one's gonna be we'll just kill the engine. We'll sit here and we'll wait, and then you guys can really see how bad the traffic is in this map, and then let you get, you know, your ideas and your pros and cons on the traffic in the game. Yeah, that car literally just did a drift on my screen. Trust me, they actually will glitch your truck. I've actually had that happen, watch this one vehicle right here. He won't even stop. See, he just had a head on over here and pulled him. It's a guy with a white and black shirt on. Or almost like a white and gray shirt. It looks like a Volkswagen or a Volvo kind of tank car. You're lucky. I just got this thing out of the. I just got this thing from the shop, and already I got into an accident with someone. And actually, the AI will. And like, so like, if there's a whole bunch of cars. Oh, here comes another one. So actually, I can get literally a whole bunch of AI drivers to pull into that. Just to glitch right into that one car, and it is unbelievable, actually. But we're gonna get on the way to the farm, but I'm sure I'm just gonna be boring you guys to death, so. This AI is like speeding, like, it's like right on my tail. Every time he stops and he speeds up and he stops and he speeds up like dude, go the posted speed limit. I'm going 15. This is as fast as this harvester can go. It goes like, well, actually goes 16, but there you are. You get to have the world all to yourself now. Jiminy Christmas. You guys to also hear the new horn that's on the new TLX truck that they made. It's like a longer version of the truck. It's like a log bed. It's kind of like a flatbed kind. It's like the size of a flatbed truck. So we're gonna stop there actually. If I remember correctly, what they can do. So we're gonna let you hear the outside version of it first, and then we're gonna let you hear the inside version. like, does the wheel ever stop spinning? Like, good lord. Alright, so it's this truck right here. Notice the pink and stuff and the white? Let me know down below in the comments if you guys actually love this color. So I'm going to give you the outside view of it. Just like your normal TLX truck, you know, that you have and that I have. Like, I have like three of these trucks, but this is like at my unloading truck. And then I have a regular, oh geez. Yeah, and then you get this loud horn. And if you go into the normal, you get this one. Yeah, so apparently if you go into the outside of it, you get a super, super high-pitched, annoying sound. And then if you go inside of the cab, then you get a good sound of a truck. And these two mods are new. It's the Lizard Pickup F1000. Based off of, I think, a 69 or a 6, somewhere in the, I think it's a 69 Ford F100 pickup truck. But for some reason, they call it a Lizard, and it's a Ford brand. You can obviously tell by the grill and the badge here. I'll back it up for you guys. Yeah, you know, you guys can obviously tell it's a Ford because of the thing. But look at how cool the lights are, though. They're actually like a cyan light blue. Same with the back ones too. The back ones are actually the same color too. So if you back up, you get that really cool like cyan and kind of like a middle mix of like cyan and white. It's really cool. Then you got another one here. This is just my work truck right here. My truck that just kind of, I like to just, you know, goof off with it and whatnot, you know. Shut that. Alright, let's get back to the field. I can't wait to see how I pull out of this one. With that 43-foot trailer. Actually, a few days ago, me and Ray's, we were playing Red Dead, and this kid randomly came up, and he thought he could pretty much attack me. I pretty much shot him with a rare shotgun, and he actually texted Ray's in the PlayStation Messenger, and he said, "Oh shoot, I didn't realize that was Doc Holliday." Or you know, like he either said that or I'm saying, "Oh shoot, you know, I didn't realize that your friend was dressed up as Doc Holliday. That definitely will not happen ever again." And he didn't. And then you got a girl, I believe. I think she was a girl. That literally tried to assault me. So she ran up and I shot her right in the face. And you could just see blood just... And yeah, she pretty much ran away from me. Like... When it comes to, you know, little younger people that think that they're tough and they can, you know, try to kill me and whatnot, they don't have the skills to hide it. Until they rank up enough to be able to shoot me and kill me and get good accuracy. Then I probably will, but, me and Ray's also, we were in Valentine, and this is the same story about it. Apparently before the lady decided to show up, or the girl character decided to show up. Apparently how it happened was, you know, Ray's actually, this lady, or this girl, or whatever, a girl player, or whatever, thought, you know, she was so tough, or whatever, that she pretty much kidnapped a person, and then hogtied him, and she hogtied a male character and pretty much hogtied him and then shot him in the back of the head and then dropped TNT down and Razor walked over and he pretty much got blown up by it. And he was laughing and I was like, dude, what the heck just happened? And he's like, I got blown up by TNT. I'm like, oh, yeah, obviously the lady or the girl dropped TNT on her and then she walked over to me acting like, say, ooh, yeah, I found someone I'm gonna beat up and be a complete maniac too. Well, obviously that didn't turn out the way that she had intended. Because the minute she put her fists up, I whacked her with my gun and then I shot her right in the face. And you could see the blood literally flying all over her face. And you know, there's some of those people that are just scared of you and then they're like, yeah, that's like the next, that's like the last time I'm ever gonna mess with that character, with that person. And then, you know, you got the people that are just so, they think that they're so tough and bad in the bone that they can just say, oh, holy cow, I see this person and I'm gonna kill him because I'm better at them at the game. And then they end up getting their, and then they end up getting shot or they end up getting stabbed through Bruce in a very gruesome and an extraordinary fight. And you know, and then they're like, oh, and then they constantly continue to kill you. And then they end up taking your killing, shooting your horse. And then you go flying off your horse and off the and going in and off of that. And it's like, wow. Those are the people I absolutely get, I hate. But I did give a comment to Rockstar Games. I commented on their channel. They actually have their own channel, surprisingly. I don't know how, but they do. And apparently, I pretty much commented on their channel. And it was an update about Red Dead Redemption or whatever. And I commented, you know, I would like to see, you know, the ability, you know, for like an invite only session, so then, you know, people that are low rank and people that don't want to deal with other people that kill them, then, you know, they can go into their own private session with their friends and just have fun, just like in GTA 5. And they actually pinned that comment down, actually, and you guys can see it on the, on my subscribing. You guys can probably go over to the channel and see the comment. I mean, you'll obviously have to look around for it, but it's in there. I know for a fact it is there. And hopefully, that's going to be coming to Red Dead Redemption Online soon. I'm really hoping it is, because I really don't want to. Because, you know, if I have to deal with any other people that are trying to assassinate my horse, you know, that really gets on my nerves. That's, like, my one biggest pet peeve on about online players. I'm sorry for that, but that is loud. Apparently, you know, it's gonna really leave me to not be playing Red Dead anymore until they come out with that. Because that's something I've been definitely wanting them to come out with, is an invite-only session, because you know how much fun that would be, and how much easier that would be, or, you know, like, on, you know, how many people would like that. Especially people who just want to be left alone and they just want to play by themselves and have fun. You know, and get to learn the game and experience the game from themselves. And hunt by themselves and shoot by themselves and kill lawmen and whatnot by themselves without having anybody interfere. And, you know, risking on killing their horse and whatnot. Yeah, that's definitely something that they need to add. And I told them that, and they didn't really, they said they pinned the comment down, and hopefully that'll be something that they bring to Red Dead. Because, you know, GTA 5 has the ability to go into an invite, because you have the ability to go into an invite-only session in GTA 5. And, you know, and I kind of looked at it, and I'm like, how come you don't have the ability to go into like, an invite-only session in Red Dead? The trailer is glitching. What is going on? And the trailer's like... What's my trailer glitching about now? You guys see this? You guys see my trailer popping and bouncing like it's on hydraulics? There ain't nothing that's interfering with it or nothing. It's just glitching and popping all by itself. Like, doesn't have nothing in it. Nothing like, you know, anything that would, you know, keep it from, you know, going every. Okay, we might have to make another trip back to the shop to sell that one harvester, because that is so freaking loud. Oh my freaking... Dude, it's not even loud when you start it up. But then when you harvest the crops, it's louder than freaking molasses. I wonder if it's an engine sound that I can change to get it. Hold on, I'm gonna take this down to the farm here real quick, because over there I've got a shop or whatever, and see if I can get this thing to kind of be a little bit less quieter. Instead of being, like, super, super annoying and loud. But yes, I did subscribe to another channel. This guy actually so this YouTuber does, it's really hilarious. So apparently, you know, he gets in touch with scammers, and then he deletes all their files and whatnot, like all their bad stuff, and he pretty much gets them like to like rage like super, super hardcore. And the scammers just go off just constantly babbling, and it is so hilarious. Like, for instance, the one I watched today was, apparently this scammer, you know, after he noticed that all of his files got deleted and whatnot, then he started, you know, babbling about, you know, how everybody lives on social security, and then, you know, all that crap like that, and I'm like, oh my god, that guy is raging so hardcore, it's unbelievable, and it's so hilarious. And, you know, and then he was complaining about, you know, how the YouTuber doesn't have a job, and he thinks he works for the government, and he thinks that being a scammer is a job, and you make money from it, and that's not the truth. You really don't make money if you're a scammer. You pretty much steal from the government. Everybody knows. I mean, everybody literally knows that. But you should check him out. It's actually really fun listening to a scammer just constantly just babble and babble and babble about everything. And then they end up raging so hardcore, it's so hilarious. Like, it actually made me laugh, because the guy pretty much roasts the scammer, and know, like, you know, he says to them, you know, you're stupid and you're not smart and all that crap. And you know, and then the scammer gets even more enraged, and then he calls him a mother effer and all that stuff. And it's like, oh my God. It's like, how does this guy would never get a job in real life. Because he'd get fired in like 2 seconds probably. But it is so hilarious listening to scammers just constantly rage over it. It's just hilarious. Trust scammers, because they're trying to use, you know, their stupid ways, and they're trying to gain access to all your stuff that that you want to find private and whatnot, and they think they're so smart that they can shut a computer down. Well, they also have hackers that aren't, that they do online hacking and whatnot, they can pretty much crash your computer, but then when you restart it, you have everything there. And that's actually what happened to that one scammer. He got so mad that he just completely tried to delete the guy's computer stuff, like his game, his web browser and all that stuff. And he pretty much deleted all that, all his photos, all his wallpapers, and just was a complete a-hole to him. But then, he wanted a $500 Walmart gift card. Like, bro, why would you even want a Walmart gift card? Especially a $500 one. So then he scammed him, and pretty much he said to him, you know, hey, you know, I got the $500 gift card that you want. And he's like, oh, really? Well, you know, if you want file back, you give me $500 Walmart gift card. And I'm like, oh my God, this person is, and the funny thing is, his description of describing him was, he was so salty. So, you know, if you know how to scam scammers and stuff and just waste their time and you know, just completely delete their folders and all of their stuff that they used to ruin people's lives and whatnot. You know, it's not against the law. You're pretty much taking them down and, you know, to make sure, you know, that, you know, nobody else gets that, you know, and deal with them in the future. You know, I mean, there's obviously apps that could do that, like Robocall or whatever, that, like, waste their time, which is really cool. But yeah, scammers are stupid. They pretty much deserve to burn in the fire that pits the underworld. They're such horrible people. I don't even know how they even get jobs as that. So yeah, you know, if you ever see a number from that you don't know, and if it's from a different country that you don't know, then yeah, don't ever answer it, because it's going to most likely be a scammer, and they're going to try to scam you in something or steal your credit card or your passwords to your computers or your phone or your websites or like your website data or anything like that, anything that's important to your computer or your phone or whatever. And they can, trust me, I've had it done several, I've actually had it happen to me several of times where I try to use my credit card and there's nothing to, because someone stole my credit card number. And trust me, I'm sure it's not happened to me too. I'm sure it's happened to a lot of people, because scammers just don't know when to freaking, they just don't know that, you know, stuff like that is against the law. And then they don't get caught for it when they really should. They should really get caught and serve time in jail for it. But, you know, some of them are from, like, some of them are from Ireland. Well, not really Ireland, but like Russia, China, Canada. I know there's some in there. There's some from like the United States, the UK, Belize. You know, anywhere that there's a scammer, they're gonna be calling you like 58,000 times a day, and it can get really annoying sometimes. That's why you know, if someone calls me somewhere, calls me or whatever that I don't know, then I don't talk to them. I don't even answer their calls, and I just say, you know what, screw you. There's some days where I actually really want to say something and just say, you know, give them a fake identity just to get under their skin and piss them off a little bit for fun, you know, just to get on their nerves and whatnot. But this one should be much quieter. Let's see. But yeah, world's filled with some pretty dumb people. You know, you got some people that are super smart, and then you got hackers, and then you got people that are like scammers. There's actually a captain of the North Carolina Police Department, or somewhere in a town in North Carolina, that actually dealt with a scammer, and apparently the person said, you know, that in like 10 minutes or whatever, a sheriff's deputy was gonna come and arrest her for like some like drug trafficking or whatever, and you know, a cop like that would never do anything like that. And I'm like, oh my god, really? Like, you're gonna really tell a captain, one of the highest ranking, you know, people, you know? And she actually said, hey, you know, I wanna talk to your supervisor and stuff like that to get it all straightened out. And pretty much, that cop, that female officer, was an amazing person, because she technically scammed the scammer and made the person hang up on them. And she pretty much made... Well, apparently she pretty much made the scammer hang up on her, which means the scammer was obviously raging because, you know, they couldn't, because, you know, the scammers aren't very smart when it comes to, I mean, you know, they may think they are, but they're not. Like, my uncle could literally hack out, like, could, like, shut down the scammer's area, because he's literally that smart. I'm sure he could hack a hacker and shut him down too. But, you know, it's just, it's crazy how, you know, one person could turn out to be a complete nightmare. But yeah, I suggest you should probably go ahead and check him out. I'll leave his name or his YouTube channel name down below in the description and down below after the video's done. And I suggest you guys go check him out, especially if you guys want to hear some scammers rage hardcore. Oh, I think you guys are gonna be in for quite a real treat for that, because it's funny as hell. But yeah, he scams like male scammers, he'll scam like female, like girl scammers, like women and girl scammers that are trying to do something stupid, and then he ends up backfiring on them and getting them, you know, exposed or whatever, and it's just hilarious. Watching a scammer just rage hardcore is like one of the best things ever, because you know, because as soon as they hang up, They knew that they did something wrong, but, you know, like, there was even one where apparently the scammer, where a scammer actually got fired from his job. Because I guess he got into an argument with the guy and apparently just, like, completely, you know, just completely just ruined it for his career. And you know what? To me, that's one less scammer to deal with. But, let you know, let's get back into it. Back into the video. Or at least get back into the farming. We'll see how. This harvester shouldn't be too loud, considering I've actually owned this harvester before. So hoping it's not too loud to where it's like, compared to that other X-Full Cow buddy.
Is this one?
Oh, excuse me. Because this harvester is from 1977. And yeah, you know, this small harvester is from the 70s, and it's really popular still to this day. I still see people, you know, using these kinds of these. I still see, you know, people using the 1660 Axle-Full Case International Combines on their farms. They're so popular. They were such a good brand. Oh yeah, this ain't popular. Okay, the field must not be fully grown yet. I got some of it out there. I'm not gonna lie though, I wish all of the like Case and John Deere tractors had those flashes on there. Because that's realistic actually. Whoever made the 4440 mod, great big shout out to them to making this school tractor. So you heard what the 4440 sounds like. It sounds like this when it starts up. And then here's what the Eastern European edition, and the European edition sounds like. Which is this is the John Deere 4755 EU edition. This is a two-wheel drive tractor. This one doesn't have the flashes, almost like the 4440 does. So. I'd really love to know if we have any John Deere fans out there and some Case fans out there too. I would love to know. I have been studying, you know, the older tractors, like the two cylinders and stuff. And I kind of like the two cylinder John Deere's. And then I have another 4440 sitting right here in the garage here. This garage should have lighting, doesn't it? Should be a garage sale right here. There's one shit. Oh yeah, right here. Okay, there we go. That's better. I don't know why I didn't turn my lights on. That was kind of dumb. That's kind of a dumb move. Huh. It's cold in there. And let me know if you guys want me to do a snow episode where, you know, when I use the John Deere's for like pushing snow and scooping snow and all that stuff. Because I got my little Case tractor for just for the occasion. This is my restored International 883 International tractor. That's still sitting there because it's a collector's item, but I will use it in case I have to. So I'll most likely use this tractor right here, the 4755, a 4440, and a truck. My TLX truck, if I can ever figure out how to get the thing to work. And I will most likely be using the one. Did I place my silo down? Mill it here. Got the feeling to. Oh snap! I didn't place my silo down. Tarnation! I thought I was missing something to my farm. So then when I get the winter mod activated, or at least, you know, when I get the winter mod on or whatever, I have a certain silo that I'm going to be using to hold the snow. And it is the big dog, the wood silo. This thing holds literally 10 million pounds of seed, and it holds all kinds of sugarcane, it holds like slurry, it holds all kinds of stuff. But I don't think it holds snow though. I think it does hold snow. I think if I activated the snow mod, I think I could get it to act to hold on to snow, I think. And then I would have to, and then when the snow season's over, I just unload it and I let the snow melt into the water, and then I unload it and I dump it in the water. So I think there's a pond near me. There. We'll get a bunker too while we're at it here. We'll get a bunker here. A silage bunker in case that we do. Okay, so if we do grass and whatnot, we'll be able to get a silage bunker too. Set it right here. There we go. We got a silage bunker now too. And then in a few minutes, we'll sell all the signs and we'll start becoming a wind energy farm. Actually, we can start selling the signs actually right now. I've got like $19 million, but plus it saves room on the for me to get more vehicles if I ever need to, or it could save room for the wind turbines I'm about to buy. Maybe I'll buy like 4 or 5 of those 5 wind turbines, and I'll put them around the farm to collect wind power. Or if I don't have it, I'll go back into the mods and I'll download the wind power mod, the wind turbines, and I'll get those feel like I don't have those, but here, I'll check here. Okay, I do not have the wind turbine decoration. I did not have the wind turbine, so I'll have to go back in and download those then. Save this up, and we're gonna go down and into the back end of the mod hub and get the wind turbines. I'm gonna double save it. That goes to the houses, and then this one will go to the vehicles. Let's go back into the mod hub because I find something else and then I'm like, oh.